What is up, everyone? A very special video. You saw the title. This game will absolutely annihilate your CPU. Doesn't matter what CPU you have, you can always push this game to your CPU's limit. So I encourage you to check this game out, at least rent the thing, or you know, buy it for what, 24 hours or so. I don't know if Steam's still doing that, where you can just test a game out, and if you really like it, you can keep it. If you don't like it, you can get your money back. But I do encourage you to check this game out. This isn't something that they're sponsoring or anything like that. This is just me wanting to show you a very cool game that I find very interesting. You know, we've talked about astronomy on the channel several times, and this game is just right up my alley. I love it. You can pretty much manipulate anything you want in the solar system, and that's what's super cool about it. I mean, it sounds kind of dumb on paper, but if you think about it, okay, so we have Earth here. Let's not even do Earth because that's just too generic. So we can double click on Jupiter, and we can zoom in. Now, this is one of the cool features of this game here, whatever you want to call it, simulator. You can control the speed, the rate at which time progresses, and that's via this toolbar down here at the bottom. So let's say I want time to just absolutely fly by. So I can speed it up to where what are we at right now? We're at 4 months per every second of real time. So right now you're looking at this as 4 months every second. So of course the planet's rotating very fast, and we can actually see it progress around the sun. And you can see everything else that's closer to the sun is moving much faster because that's how physics works. But let's focus on Jupiter for a second here. So one of the ways that we can really stress the CPU, let's go ahead and go to the add tab. Now we can add, I mean, all this stuff here that's preloaded, we can add any of this into the solar system, including stars, by the way, if you're interested in something, some kind of binary system like the Tatooine planet in Star Wars. But let's try to get the Earth orbiting around Jupiter. I don't know how far we're going to want this thing to start, but I assume that at some point the Earth will just steadily rotate around Jupiter. And you can see there are little paths that kind of project from the planet that we're about to spawn, and they kind of spin out. So that's the computer, the simulator, actually predicting the planet's path based on gravitational influences. This is where it ties into this game being very accurate. So let's say I throw the planet, let's do it fairly close. You can actually see the shadow of the Earth on Jupiter as well. It's very cool. Let's do it right here. Okay, so there it goes. It's just spinning off in the distance. Of course, Earth is drastically cooling because it's so much further from the sun than it normally is. So surface temperature, see that 1 degree Celsius. Now here's what's also very cool. We can click on the Earth and you'll see that as our surface temperature declines, the actual features of the planet will also change. Okay, so there you go. Now you can kind of see it's just more, looks more hazy, I guess. But this is the Earth frozen over, and yeah, it's very cold. Right now, average surface temperature is negative 37 degrees Celsius. Jupiter is still very hot for reasons I cannot explain. I guess when Earth got too close to it, just warmed up somehow. I don't know, I can't explain that. But we do have the Earth in orbit around Jupiter. That was our goal in the first place. And what we're gonna do is speed up this simulation. Now I want you to pay attention to the CPU usage I have right here. I know it says RAM usage below that, but this is CPU usage that you're looking at. So right now, overall CPU usage is around 40% or so. And that's just us focusing on these two bodies right here. We're not even looking at the entire solar system. All the other planets and stuff are back there. This also has asteroids included in it, comets, all kinds of stuff, even dwarf planets like Ceres and Pluto way out in the distance. So I want you to watch CPU usage as I do this. I'm coming down to the bottom here and I'm gonna increase the rate at which time progresses. Okay, so now we're at a couple days per second. There we go. Oh, there it goes. So we're at a few months per second now. CPU usage has increased from 40% to almost 70%. And I don't know if you noticed this, but if we include all the other bodies in the frame that we're currently having rendered, then you can see that the CPU usage will actually increase even more. So let's just focus on Jupiter. We'll look down. Well, that actually increased CPU usage for a second there. But our CPU usage declines because now the only thing the CPU is having to do is calculate Earth's position with respect to Jupiter's with respect to the sun. So it's not really worried about rendering the other stuff. Even though the CPU is worried about physics in general, where things are going to be in the next frame or two. Let's slow things back down. And of course, CPU usage dramatically declines. So that's one way that you can heavily stress your CPU in this game, is just by speeding up time. That is something that I mean, makes sense. You're having your CPU work much faster and your GPU, mind you, but this game is much more CPU intensive than you might think. So let's take Earth and let's do something crazy. Let's right-click on it. And all right, so we can change all of these characteristics over here. We can change the velocity of its orbit. We can change its rotational velocity, all kinds of different things, right? Let's change the surface temperature first. Let's raise it to 500 degrees Celsius. And boom, there goes all the water. You see it's just dissolving. That's actually really cool. Oh, there goes the oceans. Now, the one thing that is really gonna influence how the other planets react and how the sun reacts to the Earth, that's really cool. There goes all the water vapor. We're going to increase the Earth's mass by a metric crap ton. So let's say instead of one Earth mass for one Earth mass, which is what it actually is in real life, let's raise it to 500 Earths. Well, it got a lot bigger. So with respect to Jupiter now, it's saying that we're 1.57 times the mass of Jupiter. Let's see, let's keep going. Let's do 500 Jupiters. Ooh, Earth got super big. What is that? It's like a star now. You can see here, we're speeding things up and the planets are being heavily influenced now by the Earth. Just Mars is just going crazy. So the Earth is swinging around. Now this is what I'm getting at. You'll see this here shortly. What we're gonna do is increase the mass of the Earth again to, let's say, 50,000. I want you to pay attention to what happens to the Earth when we do this. We're gonna slow it up. And so 50,000 suns, okay, we just created a star, essentially. That's pretty crazy. So this star has a ton of mass. Look at that. Look at our CPU usage. Whoa. Okay, supernova remnant. That is a black hole. We just created a supernova in our solar system. Oh, there goes the old Earth, or whatever was left of it. Okay, I fixed it. So now you can just see CPU usage on top. You can see when the supernova occurred, we were at almost one, well, we were at 100% CPU usage. So at that point, we just maxed out our CPU. It couldn't calculate anything more than what it was already doing. We basically topped it off. And that's kind of that's the gist of this video. You can do so much with this, and I haven't gone to great lengths to make this CPU just absolutely crap itself, but you certainly could do that. Let's just end with that. So let's take a star. Let's take Betelgeuse. Check out how large Betelgeuse is compared to everything else in the solar system. That is super cool. So if we simply speed up the simulation, CPU usage definitely increases. We have that variable under control. We look how fast we can make this thing work. Like, we can keep picking it up. Look at that 80% overall CPU usage there. And it's fairly stable, too. And if we increase it even more, how many years are we... This is 23 years per second being calculated. Look at that, 137 years. We're actually inducing some lag at this point. Yep, it's definitely not liking it. But another way I like to personally overload my CPU with respect to this game is to open up a very special simulation. I like to do Saturn with rings. This is just a chaotic nightmare. Look at everything orbiting just Saturn. And this is, you know, this isn't our solar system. This is just one planetary system. Look how much stuff we have there. So we can get really fancy with this. So everything's, you know, nice and tidy. It looks all great right now. Orbits are very controlled and stable. We're gonna really mess this thing up. Let's just throw an Earth somewhere into the mix. Let's do it right there. Let's do another one and another one. That sounds good. Maybe another. Let's just, you know what? Let's just throw them all over the place. That sounds good to me. And we're gonna watch as these Earths, which aren't even rotating on the same axis, the same axial plane that all the other things are on Saturn. Oh, we had one collision. There it is. Let's zoom in on it. What's the temperature of Earth right now? Well, 2400 degrees Celsius. That's pretty hot. Okay, we had a lot of collisions. Saturn is also heated up to 2700 degrees Celsius. So we're gonna focus on Saturn here for a second. And then while all of this mess happens, we're gonna also speed up time. There it goes. Now this is actually very smooth here. We're not seeing any frame stuttering, any skipping, any stall. That it actually looks great. But the CPU is being heavily leveraged right now in the upper 70s. We increase the speed even more. Look at that, 90%. and it's not the smoothest at this point. CPU is definitely being used more than I'm comfortable with. I don't know. Let's throw in a star. Let's do the sun. Let's just pretend the sun is, I don't know, right there. Okay, and let's watch as everything just gets pulled right in. There it all goes. See, the simulation maps out every possible scenario and predicts where things will be at any particular second, especially way into the future, which is why the CPU is being so heavily leveraged. Whoa, that is a super cool supernova. I have this game linked in the video description, by the way, if you're interested in pushing your CPU to its limit. This is the game to do that with. If you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up, thumbs down for the opposite, click the subscribe button if you haven't already, and I will catch you in the next video. This is Salazar Studio. Thanks for destroying with us.